town. They're making that money, bros. Tractors, plows with flashing lights, backing up a two-lane road. They take one last lap around. That sun up high goes down. And then it's on, come on, girl, kick it on back, Z71 like a Cadillac.
Good afternoon, Jason here from Bohemia Bees. We're in the bee yard today. We're going to start our extraction process. There'll be probably a couple videos that I put together showing this how the whole process works. One of the things you do in the very beginning is you need to do a quick inspection on the supers to make sure that the wood frames are fully capped with wax, and make sure that you can pull those frames and start to do that process. In order to do that, the easiest way is you got to get the bees out of those supers. There's a lot of bees up there working, and you could easily just pull the super, the lid off, and pull the supers apart, pull the frames out, brush the bees off. But then you got a lot of activity of bees around you. It starts to get overwhelming. So one of the ways that I've read and found that are the easiest way to do that is the use of fume boards. A fume board is typically just it's a roof or a cap cover, like a telescoping cover, that you would see. These fit over 10 frames. They have a black or solar panel on the front at top half, or that's really just corrugated to create heat. And then on the inside is felt. So what we're going to do is we're going to take some of the Fisher's Bee Quick. You can get this at bequick.com. It doesn't have, it's all natural, non-toxic, made of herbals and oils and such. It's really made so that you don't have that smell of some of the other chemicals that people have used in the past to extract or to get bees out of the supers. It's a really quick process. I'm going to actually pull these top covers off, put these two fume boards on these two hives here, these colonies, and then we'll go ahead and let them work their magic and push those bees out. There'll probably be a lot of heavy bearding on the front, only because the bees might not have a lot of room in that deep, so they might push them down a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and open up any the small entrance reducers so they're not getting jammed up inside, as well as make sure that I'm smoking them a little bit to kind of calm them down and do such. So here we go. We're going to go ahead and do this, but that's how, I'm going to show you how the fume boards work. And then we'll go from there. Thanks for watching. Okay, we've got these two fume boards on top now. It takes about 5-10 minutes to kind of work its way through those two supers. But we'll go ahead and watch it. Okay, it's been about 10 minutes and we've had these fume boards put on. We're going to try to see what the first super looks like. Most of the bees are already bearding on the front, as you saw. So they're down here out on the front. Some may still be in the second super, but we'll move the fume board down once we take the top one off to continue to drive them down and out. And then we'll pull the other super. So continued progress. But that's how a fume board works. It's a little bit more pleasant way than shaking the bees off or brushing them. So here we go. Jason here from Bohemia Bees. We're back in the workshop. We're going to do the second phase of this extraction. We're going to show you how we uncap the frames and stick them in the extractor. I got some tools here that we typically would use. We've got a knife, an uncapping knife. We've got a pick to help pull the cappings off, and a roller to punch some of those lower cappings. The key with uncapping is to have a really sharp knife or a heated knife. I'm not using a heated knife on this round, but I will probably on the next few rounds, but I want to go ahead and just get started. So we're going to pull a frame out, and what we look for in a frame is something similar to this. This is a frame that's been fully capped, as you can see. Both sides of the frame is ready to harvest from end to end. It's a wonderful looking frame. We'll go ahead and uncap one. All of these, we've got four supers with 10 frames in each, so that's about 40 frames to cut through and extract. We also have our uncapping tank here, which we'll show you how that works. And we'll go from there. So let's get started. Jason here from Bohemia Bees. The next step in the uncapping process is extracting. Some may not have an extractor or maybe have a manual crank extractor. This is a Dandant electric extractor. It does 12 frames, deeper or medium or shallow frames. I've got it all loaded up with the uncapped frames, as you can see. So we're going to get this thing started and extract some honey. Here we go. See the honey's being spun out on the walls of the extractor. And it's going to drip down the sides. We'll let that spin and then we'll come back and check on it. Okay, here's the inaugural pool. First pool of the extraction season. And we got honey. There it goes. Got our honey from our extractor, which we're just draining the rest of it out now, and we're running that through a double screen filter so we can get any of the remaining wax filters or anything that's small particles. One last thing to do is to get all that honey that's in the uncapping bin, it's still dripping, capture that. So we're going to drain and filter that as well. So, here we go. Lots of honey in there as well. So we'll go ahead and filter that through. And we're one step closer.